It was a thrilling day on November 3, 1973, filled with excitement for a group of NASA engineers. They were eagerly awaiting the launch of Mariner 10, an extraordinary robotic space probe that would have accomplished what was long thought to be forbidden, reaching Mercury, the closest planet to the scorching sun. The New York Times perfectly described the mission's ambitious goals. Mariner 10 will take the 1,100-pound spacecraft by the cloud-shrouded Venus on its way to Mercury, the first two-planet mission ever attempted. It will also be the first attempt to use the gravity of one planet, Venus, as a source of energy to reach another planet. Yes, Mercury posed a daunting challenge, but NASA's brilliant minds, as you'll see in this captivating video, triumphed over the odds. They skillfully guided Mariner 10 not once, not twice, but three times past Mercury, setting a groundbreaking record in the process. The last flyby on March 16, 1975, was especially remarkable when they brought the spacecraft within a mere 203 miles or 327 kilometers of the planet's surface. From that moment on, the quest to reach the innermost planet of the solar system would never be the same. NASA paved the way for future missions, leaving an indelible mark on space exploration history. Follow me in this video to understand why it was really hard to reach Mercury, and what techniques humans conceived to overcome the problem. The speed problem. Mercury, the mysterious inner planet of our solar system, remains largely unexplored. Can you believe that only two missions, Mariner 10 and Messenger, have dared to get up close and personal with this enigma? But hold on to your seats, because there's another mission in the pipeline. Its name is Bepicolombo, and it is set to reach Mercury by December 2025. Cue the excitement! Now, each of these daring missions had to come up with their own clever plan to get near Mercury. It all depended on their goals, and let's not forget the propellant they had on hand. Trust me, reaching this planet with no atmosphere is no easy feat. You see, the real challenge is achieving the incredible speed needed to maneuver a spacecraft into a stable orbit around Mercury. Let me break it down for you. Way back in the 17th century, the legendary Isaac Newton discovered that gravity gets stronger the closer two bodies are. And let me tell you, Mercury is practically rubbing shoulders with the Sun compared to other planets. So any probe venturing near this sizzling hot planet has to fight against the monstrous gravitational pull of that fiery star. Just to give you an idea, the gravitational force around Mercury is a whopping 9 times stronger than what a satellite feels orbiting Earth. No wonder there have been only 3 missions to brave this space odyssey so far. It's no walk in the park, my friends. Before understanding what other problems might arise, let me tell you about how Mariner 10 managed to overcome the speed requirement problem. It utilized a combination of gravity assist maneuvers and careful trajectory planning. In particular, right after launch, it performed an Earth gravity assist using Earth's gravitational pull to increase its speed and set the course for Venus. Just 1 month later, the probe conducted its first flyby of Venus, passing about 3,582 miles or 5,768 kilometers above its surface, further increasing its velocity. On March 29, 1974, it performed its first flyby of Mercury, approaching approximately 704 kilometers or 437 miles of the planet's surface. At this point, it used the planet's gravity to further boost its speed and set its course for Mercury. The gravity assist concept was actually developed by Giuseppe Colombo, an Italian mathematician and engineer, who significantly contributed to Mariner 10's mission. Under Colombo's suggestions, engineers at NASA's JPL managed to put the spacecraft into an orbit that brought it back to Mercury 2 more times. Mariner 10 was shut down on March 24, 1975, when it ran out of fuel. This fantastic probe, which resembled a bug-eyed insect in flight, had made it. The 3 flybys of Mercury have contributed enormously to our understanding of the planet. They made it possible to detect the existence of the magnetic field and a tenuous atmosphere composed mainly of helium, as well as providing clues to the iron-rich core at the center of the planet. Thanks, Mariner 10. Before moving on, Be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The temperature problem. Anyway, let's get back to our problems. Our probe will in general face numerous challenges before it can safely reach Mercury, and speed is just one of them. Let's take a moment to talk about temperature, which can be quite a spicy topic. Picture this, it's winter on Earth and you're feeling a little chilly in your cozy abode. You decide to get closer to the heater to warm up, but that still doesn't cut it. So you throw caution to the wind and literally touch the heater with your body, risking a burn just to feel warmer. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do, right? Well, the same idea applies to the vast universe. The closer you get to a hot source, the hotter you feel. In our very own solar system, that rings true too. Surprisingly, it's actually Venus, not Mercury, that takes the crown for being the hottest planet. I'll explain why in another video. But for now, just remember that Mercury experiences some seriously wild temperature swings. On the sunlit side, things can sizzle up to a scorching 800 degrees Fahrenheit or 430 degrees Celsius, while on the dark side, it's a chilling minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 180 degrees Celsius. So if you ever want to send a spacecraft to orbit this fiery planet, you better make it super resistant to heat. You'll need a whole army of brilliant engineers working tirelessly to tackle this challenge. And believe me, that's just the tip of the iceberg. But hey, don't forget that every problem is a chance for innovation and discovery. For example, here's how scientists working on the Messenger mission decided to deal with the problem. The probe had a thermal blanket constructed from a kind of ceramic fabric that covered several other layers of plastic insulation. This unique sunshade was mounted on a titanium frame and was designed to protect and shade electrical components on the sun-facing portion of the spacecraft from the sun's heat. Messenger achieved 100% mapping of Mercury on March 6, 2013, and completed its first year-long extended mission on March 17, 2013. The probe continued collecting scientific data until April 30, 2015, when, under a decaying orbit, the probe was allowed to crash onto the surface of Mercury. What a grand finale! The communication delay problem. Mercury, the closest planet to Earth, is actually quite far away. We're talking about a whopping 48 million miles or 77 million kilometers distance. That's like saying you're gonna pop over to your neighbor's house, except your neighbor is on another planet. This huge gap between Earth and Mercury causes some serious communication issues. Just think about it. If you sent a message to Mercury, it would take several minutes for it to actually reach its destination. And then you'd have to wait several more minutes for a reply. It's like trying to have a conversation with your partner, but they only respond after you've already forgotten what you said. Because of this delay, controlling and navigating a spacecraft in real time becomes a real challenge. That's why when it comes to sending a spacecraft to Mercury, careful planning is essential. You need to make sure you have all your ducks in a row and some autonomous systems on board to help out. The endurance problem. But even if you manage to get everything planned, there's still another problem to deal with. The journey to Mercury is no picnic. Depending on the spacecraft's propulsion system and trajectory, it can take several months or even years to reach Mercury. That's like going on an epic hike, except instead of a scenic trail, you're traversing the vastness of space. During this long journey, the spacecraft systems have to be tough as nails. They need to withstand the harsh conditions of space and operate reliably for the entire trip. Just like when you're going on that hike, you have to make sure you're physically prepared and have all the right gear to endure the elements. In other words, it must endure the space journey. So if you ever find yourself daydreaming about exploring Mercury, just remember that it's not as simple as hopping in the car and driving over. It takes careful planning, patience, and a lot of trust in those autonomous systems to make it happen. A word on Bepicolombo. As we approach the end of this video, I would like to talk about the last of the three missions humans ever sent to Mercury. Bepicolombo takes its name from the famous mathematician we mentioned earlier, whose theories played a crucial role in the exploration of Mercury. It is a joint mission of the European Space Agency and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, comprising two satellites, the Mercury Planetary Orbiter and the Mercury magnetospheric orbiter, they will be launched together. Among other things, Bepicolombo will study the origin and evolution of Mercury, trying to unveil what its core is made of. It will also be investigating the origin of Mercury's magnetic field, not well understood yet. Speaking of endurance, the spacecraft will take 7 years to position itself to enter Mercury's orbit. Of course, to comply with the velocity requirements set by the Sun's gravity, it will make use of 9 gravitational assists, the last 6 of which will be performed around Mercury. The probe is currently out in space, and it performed the 3rd Mercury flyby on June 19, 2023. The next one will be in September of 2024. Stay tuned because we will follow the spacecraft on its way to the planet. Alright, that's the end of this video. Thanks so much for watching. Would you like updates on the Bepicolombo mission? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.